Hey everyone, this is Veronica. Thanks for joining me for my daily scent of the day video. I have for you today a very fun, simple, light, flirty fragrance. This isn't a fragrance that will win any perfume awards anywhere in the world, but I like it and I think it's super cute. It's called 007 II for her. This was launched in 2016 as part of the 007 line of perfumes. There is a number one that is in a black bottle and is supposed to be an evening seductive fragrance. And then there's a number three, I believe, also, although I haven't researched this one. This little bottle caught my eye for several reasons. Found it just playing around on FragranceNet, like I find many of my little affordable gems that I didn't know existed until I found them on FragranceNet or some other discount site. I ran across this, noticed that it said 007, and thought, for novelty's sake, I have to pick this up. My husband is a huge fan of 007, James Bond, anything related to those movies. He has watched every single one. He has made a lot of us watch a lot of those. He's obsessed with it. So I thought, for that novelty's sake, I need to get it. And the bottle was super cute. And surprisingly, the reviews were good. I don't know why I had a bias that it would be cheap smelling, or that, you know, people would think it was frivolous and an unnecessary purchase, but people really like this one. And I'm also reviewing this for Paola Bianca, who noticed that it was in the background in my video yesterday. And so, Paola, this one is for you. I think this is a fresh, fruity, fun little number, great for multiple kinds of purposes. Not maybe an evening fragrance, not something that you would wear if you're going to an occasion where there are other very strong competing perfumes. This is, to me, a closer to the skin. It does have a little bit of projection, but not too much. Closer to the skin kind of fragrance. Doesn't have a lot of sillage. Moderate, you know, longevity as well. This isn't one that's gonna, you know, perform all day long, but it'll get you through a good half a day before you have to reapply. It's got pink pepper, freesia at the top, but what I get is also a raspberry note and the champagne accord. It's very bright at the top, and I love that. I love that there's some champagne in it. In the heart, you get gardenia, oleander, which oleander is a powdery floral note. You get rose and blackberry. So it stays very floral and fruity in the middle. You do get some powder. There in the middle, a powdery note. Actually, it comes through right at the top, to be honest with you, and then becomes pretty pronounced in the middle. And in the base, you get musk, vanilla. It says it has cedarwood and leather. I can't pick either of those up. I do get some of the musk mixed with the powder as this goes into its complete dry down. It reminds me somewhat of a very light version, almost like a diet version of La Nuit Trésor. Okay, so if you take that and you pare it down to a very innocent, almost, if La Nuit Trésor is the mother that is like the seductress in the evening, then this is the young daughter of La Nuit Trésor, just finding her way into the world of being girly. Does that make sense? Soft, fresh, fruity, floral, innocent, playful, flirty. Not one that I would take seriously, not one that I would wear if I needed and wanted and was craving for other people to just bestow compliments on me because I smell fabulous. This is one that if people notice on you, they're going to think you smell fresh and clean and pretty. Pretty. You smell pretty when you wear this. And look how cute this little bottle is. Da 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 da. So that's 007 II. I would recommend it if you would like an affordable fragrance. And by affordable, I think I found this. Did I say this already? If I did, forgive me. I think I found this for under $15 on FragranceNet. It was just one of those sort of irresistible buys that I had to try out just to check out what is this 007 line all about. And in fact, I want to try number one, the black one. So that there you go. There's my fragrance of the day. I would recommend it if you're looking for one of those inexpensive fragrances that is guaranteed to smell good, easy reach, fresh, floral fruity with a hint of powder and some musk in it. Take care, friends.